Chef Garrison has created, which is the salt and pepper pork knuckle, is so delicious to me because I love that crackly skin of that pork on the outside, and the whole idea that something has been braised and simmered a long time to trap in more flavors and layers of lusciousness. So I think those are the key elements I'm gonna focus on. Lovely, lovely, lovely pork trotter. Welcome to Taiwan. Hi everyone, this is Jason Wang and welcome to Jason's Table. In my search for some of Taiwan's masterful dishes, I've made my way to central Taiwan, to the city of Taichung, where a young chef has made waves with his fresh take on Taiwanese classics. With a Michelin recommendation from the Michelin Guide for the past 3 years, this young chef is making waves in Taiwanese cuisine. He's waiting for us. Let's go find him. Hi, chef.
Hello.
Hello, 你好. I'm Jason Wang. Nice to meet you. Okay. Chef Zhen, is that right? Garrison.
Yes. Okay. 好,我们请坐.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So thanks for having me at your restaurant. I'm really excited to come here. And can you tell me a little bit about the past 3 years? What are some of the important aspects about your restaurant that you think make it Michelin quality?
其实我们的食材都是我们自己精心去挑选.
Okay.
我所谓的挑选是真的就是到了产地 去一一的去访查，然后去确认。
So my question, chef, I'm looking for some of Taiwan's masterful dishes, and I know that you have put a fresh spin on some classic cuisine of Taiwan. If there is a particular dish that you would recommend that I need to try, which dish would it be and why?
如果我要来推荐台菜的话，我觉得猪脚。猪脚。
Pork knuckle, pork trotters, yeah.
猪脚这个食材蛮代表的，因为像台式不管是结婚啊，或者是喜庆啊，或者是过年、丰年过节啊，包括消除霉运什么的，然后都会用这个猪脚来做这个料理。那这部分就是我今天想要介绍给大家的，我们的招牌菜椒盐大圆体.
Deep fried pork trotters with spicy salt. And I think that is amazing because not only is the dish itself, but it often has a lot of meaning. And I think that's a classic hallmark of Taiwanese cuisine where the food, it tastes good, but it also has history and culture and meaning behind it. So chef, can we trouble you to show us how this dish is made?
可以啊，没问题。 Yeah.
All right. Chef Garrison, even though he's young, has already earned a Michelin recommendation for his restaurant for 3 years in a row. Only selecting the very best of the seasonal ingredients available, Chef Garrison has a very particular keen eye for quality. Even the specific variety of rice served to the diner in the restaurant has been hand-selected by Chef Garrison. A really important part of Taiwanese cuisine that is unfortunately often lost in translation is the use of the name to represent something in the food. So the dish itself today is 椒盐大圆蹄. It means salt and pepper, 大元, meaning money. It's almost as if it's like a pork piggy bank. So this dish, this luscious cut of meat, is supposed to represent abundance, wealth, and hopefully lots of money coming in for your family. Porky piggy bank, delicious.
今天呢，要跟大家介绍的就是我们善心的招牌菜椒盐大圆蹄。我们第一步首先要处理的，就是我们要把这表面上的这些细毛，把它整理干净。
The use of the blowtorch to singe the hairs on the skin of the pork itself is just an extra step of care, making sure that the skin is in a nice, clean condition so that when it gets fried later and gets braised, the texture of the skin is at optimal deliciousness. A step often seen in Taiwanese cuisine is the sauteing of aromatics to bring the flavors out. Those all get tossed in the flame in oil to bring out the aromas before it moves on to the next step. The next step that happens in this dish is there is a braising liquid that gets created.
好，今天这就是我们要用的卤包，好，把这些新香料把它装好。然后我们今天准备了八角，再来还有一个比较重要的就是红谷米。
Sauteed aromatics, and then the unusual step of sauteing rock sugar until it caramelizes. That gives the rich kind of undertone of color and flavor as well.
準備好的這些新香料，還有我們的滷包。
This creates the master braised broth, lu, which is slow simmering for whatever protein, in this case pork, to give it flavor, to help develop texture, to render the fat and make the meat nice and tender. It's a technique commonly seen in Taiwanese cuisine.
确认一下，哦，这样里面都已经有软嫩熟透了的状态，OK。
The pork itself is fried twice. So the first time it's fried in just to render some of the surface level fat and lock in some of the moisture. Then of course the pork gets braised, and then the second time is really to crisp up that skin. It's coated in sweet potato flour, and going into that hot oil, the temperature is much higher. The whole point is to get that edge of that skin on the outside nice and crackly crispy, so that when you bite into it, you get that lovely contrast of texture with the rich, luxurious kind of collagen-y melt in your mouth. Fat layer from the pork paired with the crispy skin.
那我们炸好的猪脚的部分啊，我们表面撒上一层薄薄的胡椒盐。 吃饱了没？
Chef Garrison, this is your beautiful deep-fried pork trotters with spicy salt. It is gorgeous and the aroma is amazing. Chef, could you explain a little bit about this dish and the amazing things on the plate we see as well?
那这道菜其实就是我们的胶原大圆体。那这一道菜的一个发想其实是从 台式的红烧大圆体这个部分所衍生出来的。嗯，那当然在这个圆体的部分啊，我们有特别准备三款比较不一样的这个sauce
OK
的部分。那像传统的这个猪脚，我们都会有搭配这个酸菜的部分。酸菜
OK， so okay, pickled vegetable
用台式的这个酸菜下去炒制的
OK
那另外一个就是我们最主要的一个灵魂就是椒盐。
椒盐，那这个椒盐呢，
其实也是我们自己特调的一个配方。嗯，那里面有多加了一点点我们的一些
something secret, yes. Salt and pepper, but with a little bit of secret spices in there, yes.
好，那第三个就是我们这个芥末沙拉酱
，OK，
这也是我们自己调配的。OK， 哦，那其实这一道菜的一个发想啊，就是我们希望让台式的这个 红烧大圆体，它会有一个新的样貌呈现在消费者的面前。是。那我们也希望说，透过这样子的一个展现，有机会让这样子的一个菜色可以让被更多的这个国际的贵宾所看到。It
smells so good. Can we try it? How do we eat this?
好。哇。那这部分我们来，我们把它剪开。
And you can hear it's so crisp on the outside, just cutting it. And I think that knowing that you fry it first, then you braise it, and then you fry it again to crisp it, I think there are a lot of different layers of texture and flavor that you're building there, and also just to help render some of the fat in the pork.
No problem.
All right, cheers, yes.
Okay.
Okay. It's not okay, it's great. Mmm. The skin is very crispy, but it's not hard. It's like this lovely crunchy texture. And you put sweet potato starch on the outside. And I think that little bit of crunch and the just melt in your mouth texture of that collagen layer from the skin going into the fat, going into the meat is just very luxurious.
在台湾的这个小吃里面，有一道就是咸酥鸡。这个咸酥其实它最主要的这个香气啊，来自于这个胡椒盐。嗯，那我们把这样子的元素搭配在这个猪脚上面，让这道菜色是可以让更多大众所喜爱的。
Okay, so it's really fragrant. It has a lovely aroma. 香气 is and. Yeah. I love how as you're chewing, there's more and more flavor coming out. You get that little bit of the garlic and you get that fresh garlic flavor, but the aroma is just carried on the collagen and the creaminess of the pork. And you get those little hints of the pepper in there and a little hint of spice with the chili. It's like a party in your mouth. Okay, well, after eating this, it's super delicious. Really well executed. It's giving me some ideas for maybe some creative cuisine that I might come up with. Thank you so much for inviting me to your restaurant to try this. Is there a possibility you might join me at my kitchen for a dish that I can cook for you?
好啊，非常期待。
Okay, all right, so it's a date. Thank you so much, and I'll see you soon. I love that crackly skin of that pork on the outside, and the whole idea that something has been braised and simmered a long time to trap in more flavors and layers of lusciousness. So I think I'm gonna try to focus on how to get the textures that I've eaten in the dish, and also kind of some of the supporting elements that give the dish different directions and ways to savor the flavors. I think those are the key elements I'm gonna focus on when I try to create a dish inspired by Chef Zhen's lovely, lovely, lovely pork trotter. After eating Chef Garrison's salt and pepper pork knuckle, I'm here in the kitchen and I'm gonna create a dish based on all the delicious textures and flavors I had in his dish. And I'm going to use these beautiful European pears and I'm gonna peel these and I'm gonna braise them in some red wine with some spices, some sugar. It's gonna take on a lovely color and it's gonna be delicious. Pears in. Time for the braising liquid. Got some red wine. Pour the red wine over. Gonna add some sugar and some spices as well. So a little bit of cinnamon. Cinnamon as it stews in here is gonna release that lovely kind of warm spicy flavor. I'm going to put in some kumquat. And I'm gonna bring this to the boil, put the lid on, and let it simmer gently until the pears are tender and the liquid starts to reduce. Chef Garrison's beautiful pork knuckle has a little bit of sauteed aromatics on the top when it's served. So chili, some scallion, garlic, and I'm gonna emulate that little crunchy aromatic fragrance with some caramelized almonds. I'm just gonna use some granulated sugar and I'm gonna get these almonds nice and toasted. Gonna get it into a nice crisp caramel, then crush it up into little crunchy almond bits. Caramelized sugar goes very quickly from delicious golden caramel to burnt, so I gotta keep a close eye on this. I can smell that black pepper aroma coming right out in the heat. And in we go with our almonds. Smells delicious. And this is your base for like a praline. Okay, in we go, pour this out. delicious. For the item that I'm gonna wrap around the pears, what's it gonna be? I'm gonna make a little bit of what's called almond frangipane. And almond frangipane is used in pastries all over. Traditionally, pear tart, poached pear with frangipane. And frangipane is just some butter, a little bit of sugar. So I'm gonna get this worked in. Butter softened up, and I'm going to add the eggs. Almond flour, or almond meal, so just ground up almonds. And to give it that classic almond aroma and flavor, a little bit of almond extract. Just a quick taste to make sure I have that almond extract. So almond cream, frangipane's ready to go. Next, I'm gonna get the phyllo. Phyllo pastry is one of my favorite pastries to work with. I don't want it too thick on the outside. I want a nice crisp outer shell, just like the skin of the crispy pork knuckle. So I'm gonna do just a couple sheets, and I need to brush it with butter. So I have four layers, and I'm going to cut this right down the middle. I want a nice crisp outer shell, but I don't want it too thick. And I'm gonna take some of my almond cream. Beautiful pears. So pears, in we go. Wrap this baby up. And boom, right in the middle. And for some folks, it may almost seem like, oh, is he making like a dumpling? No, I'm making a phyllo purse. And I'm gonna complete that illusion in just a minute. Take out the pear stem, and what am I gonna do? Substitute it with a little bit of cinnamon stick. And our little ham legs or pork knuckles are ready for the oven. Phyllo, I thought it might be a little surprise element for some of the guests. Maybe they haven't had it before, but it just gives a completely different mouthfeel, that it's crumbly, crisp, shattering, crunchy, but in a tender way that is just the same as the pork skin on Chef Garrison's dish.
Hi! Hello!
Hello. Hello. Garrison, 你好, please. Hi, Ellen, how are you?
Thanks
for coming.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, Ellen.
Hi, Jason. Hello. Thanks for coming.
So we're in for a real treat today because Chef Garrison brought one of his signature dishes from Taichung. It's a salt and pepper pork knuckle. So you'll see what it is, but I've kind of come up with a dish to complement his. So yeah, why don't you have a seat? Please.
Hey.
Come have a seat. Yeah.
Looking forward to it.
Yes. Smells super delicious.
Wow. The presentation is so grand.
This is Chef's salt and pepper pork knuckle. So, 椒盐大圆蹄. Shifu, how do we eat this?
来帮大家服务一下.
It's supposed to have that crispy outer crust, and then the inner is kind of like melting.
The sound looks so...
Wow.
Yeah, you can hear it's crispy.
The crispy sound.
Who's gonna go first? Dig in.
Let me do the, since it's called salt and pepper. Salt and pepper, when you add it to it, it gives a popping flavor inside your tongue. It's like dancing.
So try it plain first.
It's so good.
You know, it's making me remember because my family is a hunter, so
hunter.
I go with my uncle in the forest, and we eat some deer or some boar.
Okay.
And he cooks the meat like for 5 hours, very, very slow. And the meat is so juicy, so soft, and it's making me remember this one.
Wow.
Yeah. With pork knuckle was very a new taste for me. Like the fat, I never eat a fat like this. It was very soft, very tasty, delicious. It's all melting in the mouth, and I very enjoy it there.
And I think for me, just Chef Garrison, it's that thought process of combining different elements and different textures. I mean, he looks so young, but he's a master. He knows what he's doing. All right, well, you guys keep eating. I'm gonna go get my dish, and we'll have a little bit more.
Okay.
Okay. 谢谢。
其实在这一道最主要的一个元素上，就是它是外酥内嫩，那同时它呈现的这个这样子的一个口感。那其实我很期待就是杰森这边的一个发想，那我期待他的一个作品。
And I took the little under bowls off them because I wanted the bottom to crisp up. So I'm just gonna let these sit here. They look golden, crisp, delicious, and I need to finish the plating. Almost like the sauteed garlic. And just for a little bit of extra flavor, remember that sauce we had, which is the red wine reduction. It's nice and rich, syrupy, not too sweet, a little bit of acidity from the wine, but a beautiful texture that's gonna give a little moisture when we serve this dish. So here is the phyllo wrapped poached pear. I think it's gonna be ready to go. Bon appetit. All right, time for some other food.
Wow.
Okay, so I pass this to you.
Amazing, this is beautiful.
That's the cannelle. It's cannelle. Oh, wow.
This is my inspiration from Chef's Dish, and it is a phyllo wrapped poached pear. Yeah, so you can cut into it and see what's inside. Yeah.
Wow. It's so beautiful that you don't want to cut into it. Wow, the crispy outside.
So you can see there's a pear on the inside. Yeah.
It smells so good. So good.
But this is something you might be familiar with, right? Poached pear? Wow.
Oh, yes. In family, we used to make with apple.
Apple, okay.
Yeah. I come from Normandy, and we make a very nice apple pie, so it look a bit similar, yeah.
And also the texture layer of it, outside is crispy, inside it melts in your mouth.
真的我很惊艳耶，这个没想到可以这样子的去呈现。
The peels in the middle was very cooked very well. When I take some flour and it's make like explosion in the mouth and like very surprised for the taste, yeah. I was very big surprise.
When I bit into it, that was the most amazing moment because it has the same texture, the layers, you know, the crispiness outside, the fatty in the pork, but inside with the cream and everything, it just melts in my mouth.
表皮的酥脆，然后里面的软嫩，然后层次的堆叠跟香气的部分，我都觉得哇。 还有这样子的一个搭配的方式。
Thank you.
Right.
Yeah, so very similar, like this part, like the meat and the fat is melting same as the meat. It's so nice.
其实我看到我还蛮惊讶的，我们是那么的大份的这样子的一个分量，它可以把它做成是个人式的这样子的一个方式的呈现，在整个摆盘的呈现上，我觉得精致，然后又有。 我原本的那个菜的这样子的一个雏形在，我觉得还蛮惊艳的。
I love it when people are excited about the food I make, and I think for me, I'm all about sensory things. So how things sound, how they look, how they taste. And so that's that sound of that knife or that fork going through that crunchy phyllo pastry and then boom, right into the plate, split it open, and it's beautiful. Have that experience and have that wow moment is so satisfying to me. I think sometimes, even though we don't all speak the same language, food is something that needs no translation. And to be able to share and learn from chef and exchange ideas is just a wonderful opportunity to learn and to enjoy good food and to be sparked with some new creative ideas. So this is Jason at Jason's Table, Masterful Dishes. I'll see you next time.